Welcome back to Let's Play Star Ocean Blind. Finally, I'm back. Oh, I have so many things to say. First of all, before I forget, I was running around just leveling just now while I was waiting for the apartment to be emptied so I could record. Eric... Wait, was it? Yeah, I was adding writing to Eric's thing because it increased dexterity. And then we all learnt the super specialty command publishing, finally. So I think we have them all now. And then I got Taro to write a thing just like 30 seconds ago, and she made a book. So I guess this is what that publishing place is for, because I was wondering, like, what the purpose of that was, because when you do the writing stuff, you just get skill books. That's not a skill book, so I don't know, but I don't want to go back down this tower again. I mean, I could. I can't be bothered. So, yeah, sorry. I'll just do this. This is what we made. A book written by Taro. Damor and Iska entered the large government building, still in search of the file. Oh, we can do a thing with it. Alright, I use it on... not. Yeah! What did it do? I have no idea what just happened. Oops, that's not what I meant to do. Hold on. Install things again. Okay. I need to turn down my volume, just one sec. Okay, so, first things first, I am very sleep deprived. I got 5 hours of sleep last night, which I know a lot of people can survive on, but I can't. But I'm trying to fix my sleeping pen so I'm awake during the morning. So I'm very tired. But anyway, I really wanted to record today because I have the apartment to myself today, so I really wanted to record, so here I am. Now, the first part of this video is going to be me talking about all the things that we crafted, all of the leveling that we did. As you can see, everybody's pretty high levels. I'll get to that in a bit. So if you don't want to know any of that stuff, then check the description. I will probably have written there what time to skip to. This is going to take a while, so I'll make this video extra long, but bear with me. Okay, so I'm done with the leveling. Hopefully, anyway. I at least got to a point where I was like, okay, I can't be bothered anymore. So, let's see. I'm reading from a notepad thing that I made, so it's gonna sound like I'm not facing the mic, because I'm not facing the mic. I could try to move this maybe a little bit. Anyway, okay, so, yeah, okay, so I leveled, I updated a lot of the gear for the party that I'm intending to use for the final battle, assuming that that's coming up, or rather, at least for the rest of the game. I think I have a pretty good combination here. Like, I have Eric because he's the protagonist, I have Noct because she's the protagonist. I mean, no, Eric's not the protagonist, Eric thinks he's the protagonist. But I felt like it was fitting to have both those. Plus, Eric is super strong, and Noct is like our best healer. And I wouldn't use Noct. And then Andy, because I love Andy. He has dragons. And Maylene, because she's a mage. I was originally going to have three fighters, as you saw in the last video. I had Gore as well, I think. Oh, I'm getting ahead of myself. I'll get to that. I'm not actually sure if I'm at the end of the game, but it feels like we are at least getting there. So, yeah. So I touched on a bit of this during the Star Ocean leveling stream that I did, which is uploaded if you wanted to go watch that. I don't know why you'd want to go watch that, but you can if you want. I learned many things during that stream. But I'll be going over it again anyway. I didn't really talk much about it, during the stream. So, there's a really long list of things that I did. Really long. So, I'll start with the leveling. So, I went to Fun City to do Fun City stuff. I used a guide for that. I didn't do any more of the cooking. But I did get the bunny shoes after not that many tries, actually. I just bet on the bunny shoes, like, on whichever combination got the bunny shoes, and I got it after, like, I think on the second or third go I got them, which was great. Andy has those on at the moment, actually, but anyway, those helped a lot with the battle arena, which is what I spent most of my time doing. That's the battle arena. I was going to level everyone at the battle arena, but apparently it's difficult for mages to level there, so I only ended up really leveling there with Eric and Andy. I also leveled Gore a bit when he was going to be in my party. Yeah. I did get the battle arena weapons that you get through the duel. Sorry, we have to listen to this music. I'm just sitting here in the menu. This is like the worst song to just listen to while I'm babbling. But anyway, I think it's the duel battling. If you like win 3 out of 4 or something, if you get to the end of it, then you get a weapon that's supposed to be really good, but they were worse than what I have on. I don't think any of them were better. Maybe Gore's was better. Or something, but so I just kind of got them for the sake of getting them in the end, but it doesn't really matter because they did level and stuff and it was good. I only got them for Andy, Eric, and Gore, I think. I don't think I got it with any of the other people. Or maybe Taru. I think I got Taru. No, I didn't get Taru. I don't know. Anyway, it feels like I did more, but I guess I didn't. It's not, I mean, I don't have it written down, so. So the weapons either weren't that great or they like sacrifice other things for attack, and I didn't really like that, so yes. But I used the bullying battle or something for most of the leveling, because you get skill points as a reward, so and that's mostly what I was wanting. I was wanting the levels as well, but it was mostly about the skill points that I wanted. So I did that for Eric and Andy. The first time I used the bunny shoes in battle, it was one of the battle arena battles with Eric, and it was just like, oh my god, he's going so fast! Like, they're amazing! Like you really get to have, like, the first hit. And it's great, and running away is easier, and it's just like so much faster to close the distance. It's great. Oh, it's amazing. I did read that you could steal some bunny shoes from someone in Fun City, but I didn't actually look at the pickpocketing stuff at all. Like, I didn't try that at all. I felt like if... I don't know, like... The whole pickpocketing thing seems more like a thing that you do if you're reading a guide and you know who to steal the stuff from or something. And, like, I still wanted to keep this as blind as possible. I didn't want to go get all the things that guides tell you to go get and whatever. Like, I didn't want to collect everything and all that kind of stuff because, if I wanted to do that, I would have played with a guide from the beginning. So, I haven't done any of the pickpocketing. So we only have one pair of bunny shoes, that's my point. I didn't really know if I wanted to have bunny shoes on two people. Like, I kind of felt like I should at least have one of them have some actual footwear that's actually gives armor and stuff. Actually kind of looks like Andy's wearing the bunny shoes at the moment, which is really funny. Although it kind of looks like Eric is wearing slippers. Anyway, oh, I just realized that's Eric's shirt, the black thing around his pants. I thought it was underwear. Anyway, Okay, so let's see. Yeah, okay, so I have the bunny shoes permanently on Andy now because the speed is amazing. A lot has happened with the gear, but I'll get to that in a sec. I say a sec, it'll be like 10 minutes. Okay, so the skills I was working on were towards crafting. I really wanted to do the customization and the blacksmith stuff. And then also alchemy when I ran out of materials. So I worked on all the skills needed for customization, blacksmith, alchemy, and their talents. Actually, Maiden got dexterity for a talent accidentally while she was doing some metal work, I think. She was making some accessories. Which was exciting, because at that point I didn't know you could learn talents from, like, using their skills or whatever, so it was like, oh my god! At the time. Either that or I didn't remember that it happened before. So during the stream, I learned that Orchestra, which is a super specialty skill, helps a lot with crafting. And yes it did. So I worked towards that as well after the stream. Well, during and after the stream. But only with my main party, so only with Eric Knott, Andy, and Maiden. For all the skill stuff, I was only working on them. I think my original party was going to be Eric, Noct, Gore, and Maiden, but then I switched Andy in for Gore just because it's Andy. Because I love Andy. So the plan was to level Eric and Andy to about 90. In the battle arena, and then continued leveling Noctamating in the tower in Fionnuala. Or is the tower Fionnuala? Whatever that is. Wherever it is that I am now. Which worked out pretty well. I don't think I actually got them to 90 before going to Fionnuala to level Mating. Yeah. I'm not reading what I... I don't think I actually got them to 90 before going to Fionnuala to level Maiden, especially because she was like level 66. But I did get them pretty high, like 85 or something. Enough for them to have learned the skills for the crafting anyway, which was my main goal. So with the crafting, I started out customizing stuff randomly, and then I figured I'd just look it up. This was after the stream. I decided to look it up. Which is when I learnt that... No, that's not true. I don't know. I think I was using a guide kind of roughly before the stream. Just kind of to learn how the crafting worked, really. And that's when I learnt that each character customizes their own weapons. So I had to get the customizing things for all the people in my party, which I did, and then I went back to leveling some more. Yeah, and then during the stream, I figured that I would just... Well, actually, after the stream, I figured I would just use a guide to see what could actually be customized and what kind of metal was needed with which weapons and stuff like that. And then decide what it was I was going to try to make. So all this leveling got me a whole lot of fall. So I was able to buy a lizard flask, which at the time I was just buying because I was like, oh, I'm gonna buy this because it's really expensive and I'll just buy it because I can. But then actually found out that it's actually really good for alchemy. I think it makes it more likely to succeed I think it makes it so that you can make the higher level metals or something. Which I didn't actually realize when I bought it, I just bought it because I could. I also bought one of each instrument, just because I could. Which was, like, before I was even going to look at the orchestra thing. Before I was informed that was a good thing to do. And I also stocked up on pet food. That was, like, my main goal, was to go stock up on pet food. It was, like, the only thing I was going to do, really. And level, I guess, but... So with the crafting, I started out doing random metalwork stuff with Maydene, and I used up all the metal that I had just with Maydene making accessories. I didn't actually write them all down, but I did at least get an aqua ring and a surrender pendant. And I think if we look in here, some of them I got like quite a few of them. I don't know if I had an aqua ring already, but I got that. I think I got stardust rings as well. I think Gale Earring I might have gotten. I really can't remember what I got, but there was like a whole lot of stuff. This one's new, I think, the Moon Earring. This one is new. Oh, we have three of them. Yeah, so we have that. What does this do? Oh, the Holy Ring, I think, was new. The Atlas Ring was new, I think. Yeah. But I didn't have it on because it, like, lowers so many elements and stuff. Oh, the Left Cross was definitely something she made. Oh, that increases magic? Oh, I didn't know it increased magic. Oh, although these are really good though. Well, maybe I could put that on her instead. Where is it? I didn't realize it increased magic. Anyway, oh, that's interesting. Star necklace, I think, was new. Yeah. No. Maybe? Maybe I picked it up, I'm not sure, but I didn't need that, so. Oh yeah. I also made a bunch of cards and portraits and some skill books, which I actually forgot to use, so that's great. The portraits were... I didn't look at them, I don't think. Where are they? Oh, little portraits! Come out. Wherever you... Seriously, where are they? Portraits. Metal card that... When used, gives you the power to revive a fallen ally. The scream in this penny will call forth the demons of hell and annihilate on enemies. Enlightenment gives you double your experience. Oh, that would have been useful. Oh well, a toolbox filled with tools. Oh no, that's not. I guess those are the only cards we have. Where are? Am I just going past them? Am I just dumb? Why can't I find them? Oh, here they are. Okay, Jesus. I think we looked at him already. Maybe we looked at all these already. Wait. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe we looked at them all already. But anyway. I don't know what the point of the portraits are other than to look at them, so... Yeah, so other than the accessories, I didn't really customize anything worthwhile. I only did Eric and Andy, I think, with the random customization. So, I looked up all the things you can make with customizing and blacksmith, and chose the things I thought would be good for my party members, and then used orchestra and made them. So, this is what I ended up with. I did end up being able to make everything I wanted to make. I also made a couple of extra things, because that's the nature of how that works. And also just kind of like some things like, maybe I'll change to that, I might want to change to that at some point or something like that. So I kept Eric Sacred here. I couldn't make his best weapon. I think it's like 1600 attack or something. Because I didn't have the sword that he got from... hold on, I'm just gonna have a drink. There's a sword that he gets from the tournament, which... My mouth is like sandpaper, it's so dry for no reason. I must have tried to customize it, or I threw it away, I don't know. It's not like me to throw something away, but either way, I don't have it, and that's the only one in the game. So I couldn't make his best weapon, but I think this one is still not that bad. I mean, this is like his sort of like story ultimate weapon, so I think. So I kind of wanted to keep this anyway. Same for Noct. I wanted to keep this just because, I mean, like, halves the consumption of MP, that's really nice. And it looks cool and stuff. I can't remember if there was anything you could customize that was better than this anyway for Noct. But anyway, whatever. So I made all these things. Reflective armor. Apparently this also regens, or like turns attacks into regenerate into HP. It like drains or something, so that's nice. This looks amazing, by the way. I actually thought it was a wristband, like a wristband, a bracelet, but it's not, it's a ring. But it looks really cool, like, oh my god, it looks so cool. So I put this on. He gets to have the Odin's helm. Just because it's Odin's helm. It also gives like a whole bunch of different stats, like crit and stuff, stamina, guts and stuff. So, and he has these shoes on because he doesn't have the bunny shoes, and he has the bunny shoes. So he has these. They're just good defense mostly. Then he has this, the Sturm ring. Just because, yeah. This is further down the page somewhere, I think. But I did originally give him the link combo thing, but I discovered that... I was reading that there isn't really any benefit to using a link combo unless you know which combos go really well together, like to... like cut down on their animations and stuff, so I was like, whatever, never mind. And also to have some variety. So I gave him this and said, I could maybe go back to the link combo, maybe like include the one that restores HP, that skill in there somewhere, but I mean, Nox is a pretty good healer, so so anyway, he has this. Oops. And then I gave him this, which, yeah, would do the same thing, so. So for Nox, she has the Mirage Robe. Why does she have that? Wait, why does she have the Mirage Robe? Oh! Yeah, okay. I did make two Ishtar Robes, I think. Did I make two Ishtar Robes? Yeah, just in case. Because it does raise magic by quite a bit, but I figured that, wait, she doesn't have to have this on. What am I doing? Here, she doesn't really need that on either, but anyway, she can have that now. I gave her the Mirage Robe so she didn't have to wear the stone check. That's basically the point of that. Oops. And then she has this... the rune buckler because it protects against paralysis. She has the Isis tiara because it's incredible. the witch's boots. Yeah, because she does. And then she has those. I managed to make the Maloofa for Andy. Apparently, making the Maloofa, I was reading that, apparently that's, like, common knowledge. Everybody knows that. Okay, then. It's like a famous example or something of customization. I don't even... whatever. And, like, the description of this is just, like, a pair of evil swords stained with darkness as they are said to have been tempered in the blood of the devil. Like, what kind of a description is that? It does lower his, water, I think, is what that is. Defense, which is, not good, but... look at that attack, though. So he also has reflective armor, he also has a star guard. I gave him the jewel helm. Yeah, because it has way more defense in the Odin's helm. But I wanted to have the Odin's helm anyway because it has all that other stuff. But I didn't want to have, like, both. I kind of wanted... I wanted there to be, like, a... because what if one of them's really terrible or whatever? So I just... yeah, I have a variety there. Gave him the bunny shoes. He has the mic chain on. I actually thought we had two of these. If we had two of these, I would have given one to Eric, but we only have one, so... I think. Yeah, so... so Eric... oh, I mean, Andy gets it. Especially because he has the bunny shoes, so, like, he has to... well, that's the other reason I gave him the jewel helm, because he's losing armor by having the bunny shoes on. And then the might chain also, like, increases the stuff, so... and then he has the stone check, because nobody likes to be turned to stone. Maylene! Oh, I love her weapon, the Dragon's Tusk. It looks so cool! It looks like something from Cardcaptors. It's amazing. So she has that. A legendary staff possessed of the wisdom of the dragon, increasing its heraldic power. Heraldic power. Have I been saying that wrong this whole time? And then she has the Ishtar robe, because the Ishtar robe, like, look at that. Oh. I was going to give her rune buckler as well, but then I figured she doesn't get attacked very often, touch wood. And I made this accidentally while I was trying to make something else, so I gave this to her. It looks cool anyway. An armband blessed by Kali, the mother of the dark world. And it's good. You know, I mean, it gives, like, a crit and stuff, which is good, so. Like, I felt like it was better on her than it was on Noct. Because she's the one that does all the magic stuff. Noct does it a little bit, but not as often. And then she has the Isis tiara. Why does she have the rune shoes? Oh, yeah, because they're not that much different to the witch's boots. But they, like, have different things. Yeah. So, I found the rune shoes. I didn't make them. I'll get to that in a bit. So I gave her one, and I gave her one. Again, it's kind of like, with the... dual helm thing. So then I just gave her the life cross, and she has an emerald ring as well. So that's them. What did what Taru have on? Like the angel hair. Okay. So that's all the gear. Okay. Where am I? My notes. Okay. So while I was leveling, I was going up and down this tower, and at one point I decided it would be a good idea to go to the left. Well, no, it's like to the middle, and then kind of more to the middle, and then to the left or something. because I was literally just taking the right-hand path, which seems to be the fastest up and down the tower, so I could like go quickly from like the safe point in the tower to being outside to being able to save and then back forth. By taking this other path, I actually ended up in a place I hadn't been before, because there were treasure chests that I hadn't opened. I was thinking, like, should I record me opening the chests? But I really couldn't be bothered, and I really wanted this stuff. I've written down like a massive explanation of this place, so I'm just gonna go there. I'll just show you it. I can tell you what I got though while I'm getting there. One thing. Andy has 9,999 HP, which is just like, oh my god, it's crazy. But the treasure that I got with the rune shoes that Maiden has on, Atomic Punch, Lotus Eater, which I used for one of Andy's customizations, Beta Box, and Sylvan something. I think they're Sylvan shoes. I've only written Sylvan for some reason. Something like that. As you can see, the battles are way easier now. Thank God. Okay. I have to go like all the way back down to the bottom of the tower, so bear with me. I didn't make everything that could be made, by the way. I just kind of chose like some things. I am running away from these. These things mess me up because they swallow you and it sucks. No, Eric, you got swallowed. I just kind of like chose some things that, because I didn't know the full stats of everything, I just knew like their attack and magic or defense, and stuff. So I made like a bunch of things, but I didn't make everything, because I didn't want them to be like perfectly geared, just kind of like good enough. But like at the same time, I wanted them to have like gear that was good enough for the upcoming battles, because that did so much damage. I don't want to have too much of a hard time, but I don't really want them to be super overpowered, because it'll probably take away from the story, like if they just easily win the battles. But at the same time, I do want to actually finish this Let's Play at some point in the near future. So, oh my god, that does so much damage.
They were weak.
Yeah. I'm really hoping this goes well. Which way was I going? I think I was going this way. Oh, I need to... I think I have it on so that they're looking for enemies.
I'm coming!
Sword dance.
So I made three weapons for Andy. I made the Holy Cross, the Gemini, and the Maloofa, and found out that the Maloofa was better, so that's why I'm using that. For Maiden, I made the Dragon's Tusk, which you saw already, and I also made the Silver Moon, which also looks pretty cool. Can you please attack something, Andy? Thanks. Yeah, but the Dragon's Tusk was better, I think, so I did that. And those were actually the only two people that I ended up customizing stuff for, which is really annoying. Oh yeah, which you knew already. But like, it's annoying because it's like, I leveled the skills for all the others to be able to customize one, but it doesn't matter. Because your stuff went towards blacksmithing anyway, so it's all good. Okay. Oh, wait, let me, yeah, let's do that. Oh, and do we, is anybody practicing? Oh, no, don't do that. Oops. Nope. Because, oh yeah, so that was with like lowered abilities on some of them. It's interesting. Okay, let me just. It's funny that I'm just going back there. It's like, well, I could have just recorded me up in the church. whatever. These things used to give me such a hard time, and now it's just like. Is great. I mean, I guess me going to this place gives me something to do. Well, this gives you something to watch while I'm talking anyway. I'm also like explaining stuff out of order, so I'm like it's like, I'm like going through my notes like, hey, I said that already. Oh, yeah. There's actually something in the place that I found that I want to show you. So that is, there is a reason why I'm going back there. I think I noticed it after I got the treasure, actually, so... Anyway. Oh, okay, right. Okay, so back to the crafting. Because I was doing the whole blacksmith thing, I found out about a magical rasp, that you need to make certain things, but, like, if you have it already, then you can't make the stuff that you can make without having the rasp. Oh, these guys again. These guys are good, so they give lots of experience, and lots of fall. Yeah. So, I found out about the fake gallery, which is where you get it from. And I went to find that. I didn't actually know exactly where it was, I only knew that it was on a snowy island, which really narrows it down, so it wasn't hard to find. You just, like, land on the island and you walk around and you end up at it. I should have recorded it, but I didn't. Yeah, so first I crafted all the stuff that you can only make if you don't have the rasp, and then I built the rasp and then I made all the rasp needed stuff. I also bought Sakroth's helmet, which is, I think it's a headpiece for Andy, but it's like, it's a giant bow. Yeah, and I just got it because it was hilarious.
Okay, no big deal.
Let's see. Ah, it must be an accessory. Ah, here. Oh, Sacknox. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, I assumed it was for Andy, because it... I assumed it was for Andy because of the dragon thing. I didn't realize it was an accessory. A strong dragon's helmet that releases true power after a long battle. I was just like... I just thought it was funny. I didn't get it because I thought it would be good. Stone checkers are really useful though. Maybe I'll give it to him instead of this. What was this? Yeah, maybe he can have it. Although I'd feel it more like Andy should have it. Oh! Oh, maybe it is just for Andy. Okay. Well, he can have instead of the stone check. If we start getting petrified all the time, then I'll change it, but... Okay, here, you can have that. Alright. Anyway. Are we healed and stuff? Yeah, we're fine. Oops. Wrong button. Okay. Yeah. It actually cost quite a bit. Which at the time was like, oh, it doesn't matter because it's just vulnerable. But anyway. But it's actually good, so it's, you know, it makes sense that it costs a lot. Whatever. Anyway. Wow, Nocta's really keeping us well healed, isn't she? So I also discovered that there were these... There are like these giant robotic green bird enemies in this place that I was having trouble with in the last video. And I was like running away from them constantly. Oh my god, this does so much damage! But they give like 40,000 experience or something, and like they are oh my god, I've been talking for 40 minutes. anyway. But I actually didn't come across them very often, which is funny because I was coming across them all the time in the last video. But oh well. So that was nice for the leveling. What else? There are just some. We're almost at the place, by the way. There's just some other things. I discovered the use of survival, which is a. Is it a super special skill? No, it's a item creation. Yeah, this. Yeah, which like uses MP. Oh, he's level 10 in it. Yeah, to find useful items. Yeah. This is my first time using it, I think. Okay. But yeah, which seems a bit convoluted because you actually have to go into the menu to use it. Anyway, so it's up here. It's up here. Then you take the elevator again. The teleporter, rather. While we were leveling, Maiden learned Angel Feather. I don't know if she had Explode already before I started leveling. If not, then she also learned Explode. Nocta also has Angel Feather, so no, we're wandering away from these. These are like the only things that actually kill me in this place now. Well, except for the wizards are not very pleasant, I think. Can we just run away, please? Run away! Run away! Shoot it, Eric! What are you doing? There we go. What? Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm not sure if anyone else learned things, but these are the killer moves that I have. That's not the right menu. These are the killer moves that I have set up. So Eric has Mirror Slice, and he has Dragon Howl. They both seem to be pretty good. And then Andy has Sword Dance, which I love. I really love that one. And Dead Triangle, which is good because like it stops the enemy. It doesn't freeze the whole screen, but it stops the enemy from moving, which was really good when I was leveling him in the battle arena. I keep trying to call it the battle square. Yeah, okay. So up here... Oh yeah, so I came to this water and I was like, I don't think I remember this water, and I remember it reminded me of Chrono Cross. A bit. We can win. So other than this place I'm about to show you, that's everything. Oh, that's not everything. That's a lie. Sorry, that was a lie. Although, I do hope that you don't mind that I seem to have looked up quite a bit. It was mostly the crafting. Like, I didn't look up any story or any dungeon information or boss, like, help or anything like that. it was just all, it was all just the crafting. Yeah. It was just the in that fake gallery thing. So this is what I call the four-way room, and there's this weird thing in the middle. I don't know what it is. So to the north, there's... Oh, do I remember that? Wait, what was to the south? What was to the south? Teleporter. I don't know. I must have come this way. Let me just check this. But yeah. I avoided, like, the stuff like what people think is the best gear or best accessories and all that kind of stuff. I avoided that. I didn't want to know. I didn't want to know that. I wanted to have my own, like, my own thoughts on what should be the best. It was just for the customization and the blacksmith. That was pretty much all that I looked up. And anything else that I've already mentioned. Oh, okay, yeah, alright. So, this was one of the treasure rooms, I think. Yeah, I think so. So that was that. That was one of the treasure rooms. Now we'll go back. There is a thing I want to show you, I swear. There is a thing. That's not just this treasure. But yeah. The rest of the game is going to be blind. Again, of course. But yeah. I mean, if I was playing this on my own, I would have done the same thing. I would have looked up that stuff. How to craft stuff. So other random things. I discovered that you can hurry up crafts by mashing X or holding it down. And then actually, the other day, I read that, the person in the guide I was reading was like going, people who say that obviously just fool themselves. I can't get it to work like that. Apparently it's a PAL thing. And it doesn't work on the NTSC version, so I'm glad I have the PAL version. Of course I do, because I'm in a PAL country, but like, I'm glad that it was the PAL version, because like, I wonder why that was. Because I think the frame rate for PAL is slower. So maybe they wanted to make it fairer. Because when you use Orchestra, it only lasts for a certain amount of time. So maybe they wanted to like make it so that it, like, yeah, so that it was fairer. I don't know. Anyway. The enemy. Here I go. So that's a thing. I did one private action while I was leveling in Fun City, because I actually remembered that it was a thing. I mean, like, normally when I enter cities, I enter them, like, in order to use an inn or something, and it's like I need to have people in my party when I go to an inn, I think. Otherwise they don't get healed, so, yeah. So I actually wonder what's to the left then. Oh, okay. Yeah, so there was this tube thing, and I was like, but this looks familiar. I don't know if there's another part of the tower that looks like that or something. I think this just goes up to where we were before with the save point, but I'll check.
Behind me? Be careful.
No, I don't want this. Run away, please run away. Or do that. And then run away. So I did a private action in Fun City. And I like went to... Please run away. And Andy was like in one of the shops, or in the shop, and like I think Eric was, I think it was Eric or Billy or someone was like standing like a little away from him going like, is he okay? And then I like went to go talk to Andy, and he was just like, barrel, 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 or something like that. Yeah, okay, so this just goes up top, I think. And it was just like, is he okay? I don't know what that was about. I would show you, but I'd have to go all the way back. Oh, but yeah, so I don't even... It's like, okay, Andy, I'm a little scared now, but okay. Oh, yeah, okay, so... Oh, so tired. While I was leveling, I finally got to see Eric's dragon house build. And it looks pretty cool, because it's like a dragon that appears. That's cool. I felt the need to write that down for some reason. And that... okay. Yeah, so that's, yeah. So that's it. Except for this thing I want to show you. One day, when we finish. Can we please hit that thing? That would be really great. Thanks. Yeah, which I will show you in a second. Hopefully. Well, at least we're getting resurrection from this. I'm sure that will come in handy. Come on!
You're too easy!
Okay, so... go up here. Oh, another teleporter! There is one more thing that I want to do before we take on that boss again. There is one more thing. I'll let you know what it is when we get back up there. I also need to assign their skill points. Okay, so we finally got here. To the right there was treasure, to the left there was treasure, and to the north there's treasure. I'm not gonna go in there because I'll just get attacked by things. But I noticed this thing, which looks like a teleporter, or a door, or something. And it's creepy, because it's just like, I can't go in there, I don't think. But like, it's just like a massive hole on the floor. And yeah, so I don't know if that's going to be a thing later or what, but it's terrifying. Yeah, it's terrifying. So, now that that's done, we'll go back up to the save point. And we will do the other thing that I wanted to do. So I'll just meet you up there. I mean, this video doesn't have to be any longer than it already is. So I'll meet you up there. Welcome back to Let's Play Star Ocean Blind. I'm not sure if this is a new video, but if it is, welcome back. If it's not, then finally we're at this point. So I spent everybody's skill points on stuff that kind of related to their class, like intelligence and strength and dexterity and stuff. HP and all that. Although, I put, like, HP skills on Andy, who doesn't need them, so... Oh my god, he's level 98? Oh, he's, like, almost level 100. So... I wanted to try something. I just saved. I noticed this. Now, I know that Maideen is good with the violin. I was told that during the stream. Now, because I don't need orchestra anymore, I mean, I can always make more things if I need it. I noticed that there, where is it? This one here. After Violin 1 finishes playing, a certain enemy will emerge only during situations where combat is possible. So I wanted to try this. I don't know what this is, but I wanted to try this, so. What is this music? Wow, it's really long. It's much longer than orchestra. Okay, We'll just sit here and wait. Oh! Oh, this is just a normal... Oh, I probably shouldn't have been running around. Oh. I probably shouldn't have been running around. If the song isn't still... If the song isn't still playing when we come out of this, I'll just restart again. And not move around. I don't know why I was running around like a dumb. Could we please be done with this battle now? So everybody just leveled again. Okay. For 1 second then. Wait, how can I... Okay, we can load. Alright. That's better than resetting. I appreciate that. Now I'm really hoping I did save. I did save, right? I'll be able to tell by what Maiden is wearing. Okay. Let's try that again. Oops. This time, I won't move. Well, I'll move a little bit. I'm gonna go here. It's away from the save point. This is the weirdest creepy song. The thing, like, disappointing with orchestra is that it was just the world map theme, slightly out of tune. Like, nothing happened! Maybe it will if I run around.
Let's fight!
Nope.
We can win.
Okay, then, that didn't help. So, okay. I thought maybe it would be like a secret boss or something, but it didn't do anything. At least maybe there's only like a chance it will happen. Whatever. Too bad. That was a waste of time. Yay. If you happen to know the point of that, feel free to let me know. Or rather, like, maybe not tell me what exactly it brings out, but like, if it does actually do something, it's just too annoying. If there's a real low percentage or whatever. Because if so, then I could try to get Eric to compose a song again. Assuming this isn't the last, I mean, I don't know if this is the last dungeon or not. I mean, it probably is, right? I mean, look at our levels, like. Oh my god. Okay, let me just apply these skill points again. I won't save, because like, they probably don't matter that much. Yeah, that would be good. That would be good. And he has some... Here, have some stamina. Because Andy's not already overpowered enough. I think it's funny that Andy's like the highest out of all of us. Because normally it's the protagonist that's the highest. It's funny. He doesn't need that. Okay. Let's go. I'm scared. We can do it. Hello, you weird things.
Yes, but we have guests.
The trash, they're hardly going to interfere with our plans. Let's go, Degas.
No need to hurry.
Somehow the ones below have all been killed. How deplorable. Prepare to die. Now it's your turn. Oh, ho, ho, you guys are going to kill us. Now that's a laugh. You must be joking. What's so funny? How can this guy keep a straight face? Don't get carried away. You don't know your place. Well, I have to give you credit for making it this far, but now I shall personally beat you all to a pulp. You are engaging in a futile struggle. It doesn't matter how hard you fight, you'll still lose. Uh-huh.
Ooh. This is cool.
Different music. Oh god, I forgot about that guy's voice. Alright, we can do this. Hopefully. Oh my god, hopefully. Oh god. This guy's the voice actor, like, what even? Oh my god! How did Maiden die already? Oh my god. That's not good. Okay, let's do... I'm like, just messing up this guy over here. It'd be nice if Eric could, like, help, but it's fine, I guess. Run away, Nelch, run away. Okay, that's good. Run away, Nelch. He's like, right next to you. That's like nothing. Nice try, dumb face. Ooh, I haven't seen her do this. Ooh, I'm actually not sure what that does. Does something. Oh, I see. That like kills one person and severely hurts everyone else. Is that it? No, Maiden's just dying for some reason. Okay, then never mind. Do bring back Maiden, please. Knocked. I don't know why Maiden hurts so much from that. Interesting. God, my controller is rumbling so much. What, this is going a lot better than the last time. Jesus. God, these guys have like all the health in the world though. It would have been impossible with the skill level that I had before. It would have been just absolutely not gonna happen, I would say. Because we died pretty fast that last time. This time it's just like... we're alive, except Maiden keeps dying. Although Maiden has like... I don't know... she's a bit lower level now. Her health isn't so good. Oh no, it's alright. Well, I don't know then. I guess she just has pretty bad armor. I mean like... defense. She's a mage. But although she should have pretty good magic defense, so I don't know. Maybe it's just not a thing in this game, magic defense. At least he's not doing it anymore. I guess Eric keeps interrupting him, which is good. What am I trying to say? Keep it up, Eric. Yeah. So hard for me to give Eric praise. I don't know if you noticed. Can you not do that at me, please? Like, what even is that? Could you keep that away from me? I'm just thinking she's doing that and not explode. Maybe this is better than explode. Time blast. Wow. That reflective armor seems to be pretty overpowered. It's great. It's great. I don't like calling things overpowered, like... I don't know, it's like an insult to the people who made the game. You know? It's an insult, really, saying something's overpowered, so I... But it is powerful! Yeah. Sorry for the button mashing. That's all I can really do. not a mash. Oh! Yes, what was that noise? What was that noise at the end that he made? That was terrifying. We got a fairy tear. Okay, that was, oh my god, we were like at full health. I feel like we cheated or something. Thank god. That was too easy though. Ha! Do you think you can kill us? I'll try. Bye. Only two more. Let's go back and save. Please. Please. I just realized that it says Starish in the second story. It's like with a two. I could have like, all this time, I could have like, had a shorter video name. Video title, all this time. Whatever. Too bad. Oh, okay, we have to go up here now. Another teleporter. Just how many levels are there?
Let's fight! We can win this!
Yes, we can. Excuse me, Mr. Things. Oh, good. I'm paralyzing stone. That's great. And poisoned.
Awesome.
Although the S looks like a G and the P looks like an F. So I don't really know what those sounds are. Thank you, finally. Why did it take so long? And of course everybody levels.
Again.
This way. Oh! Okay, what is this? You see a switch, will you push it? No? What's this way? Oh my god, there are just switches everywhere. You see a switch, will you push it? Absolutely. Oh, okay. Was that light coming from at the bottom of the screen? Oh! Oh, hello. Alright. Oh god, there's more! What the hell is happening? Right. Ah! Oh. Okay, left. What the hell? How am I supposed to know? What am I doing? Am I just trying to find a way through, or...? Maybe I'm just trying to find a path through. Like, maybe I'm not supposed to go everywhere. Wait. Wait. Oh, I can't push that switch again, that's interesting. Well, maybe I could push it again, but like, it's already been pushed. That's what I mean. Alright, I guess I'm just gonna try to find a way through. Middle. Ooh. Oh my god, this is just ridiculous. Excuse me. Okay. Left. Maybe there was a door back there. Then. Whatever. The lift. Up. Okay. Uh, Right. Okay. This is not as easy as I thought it was gonna be. Weft. Let's go down. Middle. I hope you know I have no idea what I'm doing. Oh. Oh, crap. Okay. What the hell is this puzzle? What the hell is this puzzle? Why is this a thing? Why? Alright. Oh, that's already pressed. Hold on. Middle. Ooh, here's a thing. Oh, what's this way? Oh, okay, that's the left switch. Alright. Yes. So I assume I have to find all the switches and press them. The ones that like aren't like this in the three. I'm guessing. I don't know. Left. Nope. Right. Nope. What? Middle. Oh my god. Okay, right. Nope. Left. Maybe I have to go around to do that other one. Or so I don't know. Is there anything this way? To the left. That's the wrong thing. Right. At least I'm not getting attacked. Touch wood. I appreciate that very much. Oh, here's a switch. Hello. I will push the switch. Yeah, I assume that's what I have to do. Lift. And then middle. Hope I haven't missed anywhere. Oh, hello! See, I switch. What does this remind me of? Oh! Oh! Something made a noise. Reminds me of something. I can't think of what, though. I mean, what of? Oh, it kind of... I think it reminds me of, Zach McCracken, although I don't know why it reminds me of that. But I think it does. Right. Oh, whoops. Middle. Oh, thank God. There was some level of terrible. I fixed the puzzle! I don't know how, but I did. Yay!
Who designed this?
What is this? The Philosopher's Stone? The basement of Hogwarts? Okay then! Maydeen just like... she just like annihilated those things using a lightning attack. That was beautiful. Okay. That looks like that's gonna be a door that's gonna shut on me or something. I'm gonna go this way first. Okay. Never mind, I'm gonna go the other way. I don't know which way to go. Oh, it didn't shut on me. Alright then. Ah! Random battle scared me for some reason. Random battles are scary, you know. Haha! Everything dies so fast, it's beautiful. Although that gave me like no experience, not that I needed, so whatever. Oh, it like leads me to the same kind of... Probably didn't matter which way I went. Oh, a save point! Hello, don't mind if I do take the save point. Thank you very much. Actually, I'll save in slot one. For a change. For a change. Now, because there's a save point here, I assume that means there's a big boss battle coming up. So I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna go the other way, see what's on that other side. Because it could be something nice. I don't know. Or there could be things to kill me. Or there could be another save point, in which case I'll just be very confused. It probably just lead to the same place. Can you attack something, Andy, instead of the air? That would be great. Come on. Thank you. Those little things are hard to hit.
You're too easy.
It sucks. Oh yeah, are we all like, do we have... I assume we have the black bears and all that. No, we don't. Okay. Andy. Oh yeah, I was reading also that as your specialty goes up when you call like your familiar or whatever, it changes which bird. That's why it says eagle has come to you. Like it starts off as a dove and then it goes up to other things like hawks and storks and stuff. It's just like I don't think I ever saw those. I think I got it to level 10 before I used it, which is a shame. So like that's really cool. It was really cool. I don't need those. Take some of those. Yes, please. Goodbye, little birdie. Goodbye. I go this way. This is quite the tower we're in, by the way. It's quite the tower. What level are we on? It's like 7 or something? This is probably the final floor, because like... 7s are significant in Japanese culture, so... Yeah. And also, my granddad's lucky number. It was 7 and... something else, I can't remember what the other number was that he considered his lucky number. It was like 7 and 3 or something. 7 and 9. I can't remember. But definitely 7. And orange and orange and black were his favorite colors. Yep. The end. That's the end of the story. Ooh, there's like a big eye. I think it was the top of the door, but it looked like an eye, and it scared me. There we go. It is over. Let's hurry up. Shall we? Should we? Yes, let's. Oh, ah, oh, scares me every time. I'm still not used to it. Every time. Okay, we go this way. We go up here. Oh, okay, I thought it was gonna be a dead end. It's like, spark acquired. What is that? A weapon that attacks the enemy by emitting a strong electric shock. That is probably for Taru. Taru, whatever. Depends which language we're speaking here. Yeah, it is for her. I'll just put it on anyway. I really hope this isn't like a certain Final Fantasy where you have to use all your characters, because, We can win. Most of my body's gonna die, otherwise. Oh god, I hope it's not like that. Oh god! Please no, I don't want to have to live all the other guys as well. Oh. I mean, I don't know, I guess the leveling didn't take that long. It took a couple of sessions. Like, I haven't been leveling the whole time that I've... between the last video and this one. I think like three separate occasions. Yeah, because there was one session, then I did the stream, and then I leveled day before yesterday. So, yeah, it wouldn't take too long, I guess, but... Oh. I mean, I love to level grind, but I want to finish the Let's Play, please. It would be different if I was just playing it on my own, but I just want to finish this project early, because it's been like... How long has it been? Like 5 million years. It's time. It's time. Come on. Let's move on to other RPGs, shall we?
Coming.
It would be nice.
Hey.
Actually, while we're just sitting here, running around, I have a question for you guys. Would it be too much if I uploaded 2 RPG videos a day for like the weekdays of a week? Or is it better that I alternate them like I am at the moment? Because when you're like just starting out Let's Playing, like all the guides are like, don't upload too much on one day because people will get overwhelmed by how much there is and they will stop watching their stuff or whatever. I mean, that's not really why I do it, but...
Let's fight.
Well, and also it's like to make it so that you're not just recording forever, so that you also get to have a break as a Let's Player as well. But I have nothing else in my life, so... I could just record all the time, and just upload all the time, and finish my projects faster, but would it be too much, for you guys to, yeah, like, to take in, like, she's uploading, like, so many Let's Plays at once, and I don't have the time to watch them all, and I'm so behind, and, like, is that annoying, or is it good that there would be lots of stuff to watch? I mean, I would like to think that it would be nice if there would be lots of stuff to watch, but I understand people have lives. And they don't want to spend their whole day just watching Let's Plays. So, yeah. I'll just save again, even though I picked up a weapon I'm not going to use. But anyway. Yeah, so just let me know. I mean, I really should make this like a poll or something, but it's easier for me to just ask the people who are actually watching this, are actually watching my videos, so... Yeah.
I'm coming.
Let me know in the comments, or you can write it on my discussion. You can tweet me, send private messages. You can contact me in any way that you wish. But it would be nice to know. Yeah. Cause it's hard to know. It's really hard to know. I mean, I know it can be hard to think of something to comment on a video, so it's hard to tell who's actually watching and enjoying the videos. You know? Yeah. Yeah. But like, even for me, as a watcher of other people's Let's Plays, I don't comment every video. I try to comment, but like, you know, there's not always something to say, so... It's fine, I get it. Okay, it's a lot of skill points. I might as well put them on, I guess. Okay. Did he learn all the... Okay, he did. Might as well do this. It's funny because Andy's like really behind in like the skill department because I like don't normally have him in the party. So that's funny. It's funny. What was I giving her? I guess that's all I can give her. Well, I could give her... Oh, no. For Andy. Yeah, you can have this too, because MP's good. Not that we really, like, I mean, we're so... Oh! Andy's level 100! Look at that. Look at that. But it seems he can still level. You can go higher than 100 levels in this game? That's, very strange. What's the point if the HP is already at 9,999? That's very strange. Oh, something glowed in the background. It scared me. Oh, there's a door. Oh! Can you not wiggle your butt at me, please? Is that what you're doing right now? Just stop that. Is there a breeze in here? It's blowing your cape or something? The fact that you have reached this place means that the only surviving members of the Ten Wise Men are myself and Indalecio behind me. So, we did kill those other guys then. I thought they were all like, you don't kill us. That's right. There are only two of the Ten Wise Men left, including you. Go quietly and give yourself up. So, they are dead. Oh, are you laughing? Hehehe, just as I figured. Just two of us left, which means we each control more. What the hell is Alexi's voice? What's the meaning of that? Ha ha ha! Now, if only that fool Indalecio is killed, the whole universe will be mine! That bug-filled, defective fool doesn't... Bug-filled? Does not even deserve to be an enemy of mine. So are they getting stronger the more that we kill them? Interesting. Can't believe it! Did you intentionally allow your own allies to be killed? Seems that way, doesn't it? Oh, that's right. Oh, that's right. Now that you mention it, you are still alive. You have unwittingly worked wonderfully as my pawns. You have earned a reward. What do you want? Money? Status? You still look displeased. I suppose you want death after all. Yes, yours. Whoa, he has, like... okay, there we go. He's weird. He has a weird voice. Also, he has, like, fire wings or something. He has a cool robe on. We are, like, doing no damage to him. I'm scared! Please let that do a thing. Hadean's attacks are so ridiculous. Nope, that did nothing. What the hell is... What is this and what is this? Holy crap, that looks really cool. Are we gonna die? I mean, we are hurting him a little bit. Sometimes. Oh, there we go. Okay, that's better. Maybe he had to let his guard down or something. Is that not doing that? Is that necessary? Like, why are you doing that of all things? Yes, let's go, Eric. Let's go, come on. Keep going. We're actually hurting him, it's good. Let's go, come on. Eric! I'm just kidding. Oh, maybe it's the guts thing. I don't know. This music though, it is something. It's good. Yeah, something. I like how we're just interrupting him constantly. It's like, yeah, that's right, you don't do anything. Wish I could remember what fairy feather, angel feather did. It's something. Obviously. It's like, it's not shell. That's, Auntie, or Auntie, as Knox pronounces it. I think. I'm not sure what Angel Feather does. It does something. Obviously. Look at all those skills. This is just silly. Is this what it's supposed to be like? I feel like I'm cheating. Oh, he disappeared. Oh, what is he doing? Oh, you think you can do something fancy? Well, I'm gonna explode your face. Sorry. That was good timing, Nadine. Very good timing. Wow, that did 9,000! Nice. I mean, like, I expect that to do that against, like, normal enemies, but against, like, a tough boss. I'm not complaining. Okay, this explode animation. So it takes forever. Controller rumbles very much. Knox, could you heal Andy, please? He needs it. Thanks. That would be nice. No, you're just gonna do Angel Feather? I wish I could remember what that was. Actually, I'm gonna have a look. One second. Oh, I can't remember. Angel Feather. Oh, so that's actually very good right now. Okay, thanks. Thanks, Knox. That's great. You keep doing that. I like how she does it on Andy. I think. Isn't she? Maybe she's doing it on Andy. Whatever. I think Maidine just waits for him to do that attack before doing his. Which is good, because it interrupts him. It's great. I appreciate it very much. It's weird that we couldn't, like, hurt him at the beginning. But then he did his attack and now we're able to. Very strange. He has so much health! Can he die, please? Oh, she's doing it, like, on everyone. That's cool. Oh, look at her! She's all, like, determined, like, I'm ready! That is totally her voice. Let's go! Ooh-wee. Can he come back, please, so we can keep attacking him? That would be great. Oh, she did it on Maidine. Oh, okay, so she must just be doing it. That's really nice. The AI in this game is pretty nice. I mean, it would have to be, because otherwise it's like, this kind of battle system just wouldn't work otherwise. Oh. Come on. Word of death! No, you don't do that. No. You can try. No. Guts. I don't know what guts does. Does that, like, stop you using MP or something? Does something do with stamina? Oh, mental training. Workout. What? There's a lot of experience. What was that, like, it was just like, no! Like, what kind of a final word was that? No! Ah, so close. I was so close to taking the whole universe for my own. Bye! Yeah, there's only one left. Yep, I'm gonna do. Oh, it's gonna go save. Right, let's go, Knox. I know, Eric! Yeah, I know. Yes. It's like, yes, Eric. There's probably another save point, but I'm gonna go back and save. Not that I really need to, because I'm so incredible, but it was such a long fight, I don't want to do it again. So, let's save. No, why do I keep it in slot 2? Stop that. Okay, I'm really sorry to leave at this point, but I've been recording 45 minutes, so I'm gonna see you next time on Let's Play Stars from Blind. Hopefully it's the end, but it might not be, I don't know. We'll see. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.